welcome to the D. So, I did try to record something, but it kind of failed, so we're gonna try this again. And, so, what the D is it's basically a murder simulator. We're gonna kill our sister, and we'll get into that whole story bit in a moment. I've actually completed this game 100%. I've gotten all the endings and everything. We're only gonna get one ending for now, because I have the next game in the series, which is the Leaf Dynasty. I believe these are the only two games in the series, but it's a really interesting game. It's wonderfully simplistic. It has kind of a complex dialogue system, and it's really interesting. So let's go ahead and start. Pilgrim Adventures. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and play the intro so you guys can see. Okay, so F1 is game options, F12 resets game, Alt-Enter is full screen. I've already adjusted my recording software to this screen, so this is what we're going to use. And Escape is access to the menu and inventory. Scotland, November 1945. My name is Aaron Bruce, son of Malcolm Bruce, and rightful heir of the Dunchill House. I have no idea if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Let's just roll with it. I have recently discovered that my tyrant of a father intends to disinherit me in favor of my deranged younger sister. My relationship with my family is strained, to say the least. I have decided that the time has come for my sister to be removed from this ghastly equation. I intend to put her out of her misery. Unfortunately, my sister never leaves the confines of the Dunchill House, which makes the matter more complicated. I have not visited the family home in quite some time. I can't bear to be in that hellhole for long. However, my presence on the night of my father's 50th birthday will cause no suspicion. I must choose the timing and method of the deed very carefully. We will not be doing this carefully. I don't remember anything of how to get any ending, so we're just gonna kind of do things randomly. Tonight is the night I go, and it is done. The bell invites me. It's been, like, a year and a half, like, between a year and 2 years. I don't remember a lot. Take your coat. So we're gonna play this very, non-suspicious. Like, we're not going to flirt, and we're not going to be standoffish, because that will only raise suspicion later if my memory is correct. Yes, take this blasted wet thing off me. You're new, aren't you? Sophia is my name. I recognize you from your pictures, Mr. Aaron. Iran, something like that. I'm not new exactly. I've been employed by your family for almost a year. It's just that you have never visited before. I've been busy. My work keeps me very busy, unfortunately. I understand. I've been away from my family a lot since I started this job. You are here now, and I'm sure you are eager to meet with the others. Your father is in the library on the left, and your mother is in the parlor, which is on your right. Your sister is upstairs in her room, I think. Thank you. Thank you for your help, Sophia. You are welcome, Mr. Aaron. I will be in the kitchen preparing dinner. I'll sound the bell when dinner is served. Which won't happen until we have both a piece of evidence and a murder weapon. So let's go visit dear old dad. Even now, the familiar musty smell of your father's library fills you with dread as you step inside. You have too many bad memories of this room. Oops. Your father's best friend, I'm thinking about The dog looks at you for a moment, then walks away when it realizes you have no food. Hello, Father. Your father remains silent for several moments, and a chill seems to pass through the library. When he finally speaks, it is a quiet and bitter tone. You told me you never entered this house again. Why are you here? Of these three options, I think this one is probably the most amiable. See you, of course, Father. Happy birthday. It's obvious why I'm here. I want to put all that unpleasantness behind us and wish you a happy 50th birthday. Happy? You honestly think this is a happy day for me? Another day when I can watch my life's work crumble into nothing? Another day to see our bloodline slit its own throat? You know how to make me happy. Move back to Den Chill, take your proper place, and do your damn duty. You have to let me live my own life. I refuse to move back here and suffer your abuse. I will consider it if you leave my sister's things here. So we don't want to raise suspicion about, like, offing our sister or anything, so we're just going to say you have to let me live my own life. It's too late, Father. I have my own life now. My home, my own job. Damn them both to hell. Do you think your pathetic little life really means anything? You are the last of a noble dynasty that stretches back hundreds of years. What does your life mean next to that? Everything. You're the same snot-nosed brat you always were, boy. Obviously, I didn't give you enough discipline as a child. Everything else is a bit too aggressive, so... I can see you're determined to be impossible. I think we had better end this discussion now. You are the impossible one, boy, as always, but I think you're probably right about one thing. This conversation was pointless, and now it's over. Get out of here. All right, Dad. This is half the tone of your sermon was where you feel sleepy looking at it. All right. Let's go find Mom. I see you made it, Aaron. Forgive me if I don't stand. Your mere presence is almost giving me a heart attack. Hello, Mother. Please sit down if you want to talk properly, Aaron. I don't want to pin my neck looking up at you. Okay, so...
If fine, I must declare, but I am going.
So, Aaron, you finally managed to make it out of here for a visit. Please tell me you aren't just here to cause trouble. I'm here to make amends. No, Mother, I'm not here to cause trouble. Quite the opposite. Oh, our family has been dysfunctional for a long time, and I have to take some responsibility for that. For what it's worth, I apologize for any stress that my behavior has caused you over the years. I see. Well, forgive me if I'm a little skeptical about your sentimental attitude, Aaron. However, we can get through today without any problems, and I appreciate it. You've been a Try to pose this as a suicide. Hopefully. Are you sure you want to take the rat poison when you can only pick up two objects? Yes, I'm sure. You take the rat poison and hire another person. Yes, poison is a nice clean weapon. At least in all those murder scenes you used to read. First, we want to take a look at this mirror. You look at your reflection in the mirror. Funny, you don't look much like a murderer. Okay, I guess not. Oh. Mother says dinner is ready. Go away, little rat. Jennifer, what are you doing? Why do you stare at your reflection like that? Stop making fun of me. I'm not making fun. I really want to know. I just wish that. What, Jennifer? What do you wish? I wish you'd drown in the lake. Mother is waiting for me. My sister's obsession with mirrors goes right back to her childhood. I never did understand why. You enter a surreal atmosphere of your sister's room, mirrors of various sizes covering the walls, creating an aerial illusion of a crowded space. Aha, I thought I smelled a rat. Have you come to see me, little rat? How are you feeling? Hello, Jennifer, how have you been? How have I been? What an odd thing for a little rat to ask. Normally, they just say sweet, sweet. You used to have a pet rat, didn't you? Remember what I did to him? Oh, how he squeaked. Such great pain for such a little creature. What did you want to talk about, little rat? The mirror thing, it kind of seems like it might not work. We're gonna see what this is worried. Well, this says your condition has been getting worse. My condition? What condition? I don't have a condition. You want to have me sent away, don't you? Well, it won't work. I won't, I tell you. Go away. I don't want to speak to you anymore. So many mirrors. Ornate Fox, our sister's third love, right behind here is in cruelty. Thank you. step inside your former bedroom now, a simple guest room. Most of your old furniture has vanished, probably thrown on a bonfire no one will bother. Here are friends and friends. Back in here. I feel like it's a suicide note or something that should be the dusty old wine cellar is where your father likes to practice billiards. The laundry room is next door and beyond that the servants' quarters. Billiards cue belong to your father. Lies across the table, this is something so you can find out about the murder weapon. Something to really make this appear like a suicide. Well, I guess nothing else can be helped. Phantom is not changing your living prison. It remains a prison time capsule of your childhood. Both of the workers will find nothing apart. Okay, so there's like nothing. My best guess is to take these letters of hers. And then see if there's brother isn't looking for the other people to be able to test me on the other side. It seems to be filled with this memory of like all the animals. Tends to shiver through your bones. The whole leather taunts your brother used to be a child. That's a kind of thing. It's not what I want. Not helpful. I don't know. Of course you do. Use that head for once, boy. Great Uncle Thomas? Sigh. What initials do you see on that silver CB? And what kind of half-wit spells Thomas with a C? I don't know. Well, I do. It's the kind of half-wit that's standing next to me. Now, which of your ancestors owns a silver chalice? If you get this one wrong, there will be serious consequences for you. I'll say one thing to my father. His style of parenting has always been consistent. Alright, so we're gonna go back up to our sister's bedroom and see if we can find, I don't know, something relating more to her condition and her previous suicide attempts. The only thing I think we found in here would be under her. Alright, it looks like we're gonna just take the letters. Because I don't know what else to do. I know that there's a way to get to create the evidence of, like, a suicide. I thought this was the one to get, like, the maid. But to, like, pin it on the maid, but maybe, maybe not. I don't know. Take the most intimate and loved one poem you can find it and write it on your person. If you plant in the right location, it could raise interesting questions about the relationship with your sister. So, I mean, I guess maybe we'll change and just try to pin it on the maid. Again, the bell invites me, this time to dinner, it seems.